Today we embarked on an exercise of part of government initiative to assure Kenyans of government stand, and also to ensure Kenyans that the government is always willing to stand with them in all situations. We are representatives of the government in terms of enforcement of all government guidelines, and today we started our program this morning, and we went to health practitioners and targeting doctors, nurses, health workers, community health volunteers, and we went there to appreciate them by way of giving them flowers. So we gave them flowers today to appreciate them and encourage them to do more, because this time it is the time we are fighting with a pandemic that is invisible, that needs all concerted efforts from all agencies and from all Kenyans. So we chose to go and welcome our medics to what we normally go through, that it is only resilience that will make us win. We went also to celebrate 98 cases that have recovered, to appreciate them to do more, because those are lives saved. And the Minister of Health, and we wanted to appreciate by actually giving them flowers, the few that were there. We were targeting Minister of Health representatives or staff, 200 of them, and we rewarded them and appreciated them. And the extension of that program was actually targeting members of the community who are vulnerable. We went to our pockets with our colleagues behind here and others who are not there. These are the representatives on their behalf. We went to our pockets and the friends around us, at least to go and buy something little for our vulnerable communities. And we are targeting at least 100 people, at least to give them something that will sustain them in a week. So that is the march, and we are still going to other groups. We place them in small groups for the purpose of maintaining social distance. And we are done with this area, Mola, and we are now proceeding to Karapul, where we have a small group of members of the community. Please appreciate them and encourage them to keep safe, wash hands, sanitize, and also observe curfew hours. We've been having programs, and even our female police officers have been having programs with women in the villages. We've been having these continuous programs to educate them on the processes of women rights and how to program the issues in terms of cases that are being processed within police stations. So they have been there in the field, led by, in Siaya here, we have a team of OCS for Siaya, Madam Frida Karegi, and others who have been going to the villages to educate them on how to handle themselves in case they find themselves into situations that need police attention, how to preserve evidence, how to secure it, at least to enable the police expedite the process of nailing those ones behind those acts, especially on offences, on sexual offences.